Top of the hill, Cindy Nelson. She has been the heart and soul of the U.S. ski team for over a decade, now in her 13th year. A bronze medalist in 76 in the downhill at Innsbruck. And here's Jim McKay with a profile on a great competitor and a classy person.
Cindy Nelson had been training hard for years when she finally made her first Olympics in 1976.
Here she is in her first Olympics at the age of 20. She's in the starting gate. A lot of pressure, Bob.
Only the hopes of the U.S. team in this event particularly do ride on her shoulders. The other girls are inexperienced.
And Cindy Nelson has won a bronze medal. Cindy Nelson has been...
And four more years, hoping for a gold at Lake Placid.
This has not been one of Cindy Nelson's better years, and she has got to be terribly disappointed.
There will be no medal for Cindy Nelson in these Olympics.
I'm out there because I want to win, and I feel I've always been a contender, and I never have done it. So for me, until I can do those things, I'm sure I'll always feel as though there's something left undone.
So now, at age 28, she'll try one more time. 2 months ago, it looked like Cindy's hopes were finished when she injured a knee. But she's fought her way back, as she has before in the lonely years of training.
I don't love being away from home. I don't love being away from my dogs or away from my family or a mate of some sort. It's hard because you can have a boyfriend for a while and then now I'm kind of giving up on him. You know, I mean, after I just start going, okay, my dogs are the best mates I got. They're always there when I go home. You don't have to worry about them. They aren't going out with some other girl when I get home.
It's an ancient line, but true. Cindy considers herself an older and a wiser woman.
When you're young and you're good, you're a very good ski racer before you even know it. And it's once you start to know it and start to analyze things that you lose all the greatness about yourself. After that kind of passes through, then you develop again and you can see things clearly. I know myself a little bit better. I'm easier on myself. I train harder, more effectively. You know, the older you get, the harder you have to train.
In the little time left between training sessions, she has a limited social life. Here she's with Ben and David Gajewski, fellow ski team member Karen Lancaster, and her dogs.
I'm not a very social person in a lot of ways. I enjoy people, but I'm kind of quiet, I guess. The friends that I have that I associate with are very close friends. Karen, my family, Gunnar and Jesse. You know, these are the people I do things with.
So Cindy slogs it out one more time. The future could be a problem. Sure, she has those few close friends and the dogs. But after 13 years on the ski tour, will that be enough? What's next for Cindy?
I don't know what will happen next, but I want to take some time and kind of ease into a lower key life and eventually live happily ever after.
The kids on the team call her Grandma. What does she think of that?
I'm not a grandma. Do you hear me? I'm not a grandma.
And here's Cindy Nelson up at the start house in her 13th year, skiing with a brace on her right leg. We told you about it. That means we will have surgery immediately after these Olympics. She's on the course, Bob. The bronze medals in the downhill from 1976. She's trying to turn it into gold here in the giant slalom.
You know, this is an amazing girl. I have to think back to 1972 in Japan. Prior to that Olympics, when she was a youngster, obviously, she had an opportunity to ski in that event. You know, Frank, I'll tell you, coming back from an injury, the reason she didn't is she dislocated her shoulder in a fall in Grindelwald, Switzerland. So I'll tell you, I don't think she really has a chance realistically to do well. We're going to know, though, right after this run.
That's the intermediate time on the left. And she is in third best at the moment at the top of the hill. So this is Cindy Nelson. She'll really have to turn it loose here in the bottom if she has any chance for the medal.
Well, watching her in Megève, France, a few weeks ago when we did the giant slalom event there, she said before the event, you know, I am heavy. I don't think I'm going to race here. I don't know about my injury or anything else. And all of a sudden, she entered the race, and she had a pretty good time. So who knows? She was a little behind up above.
Cindy Nelson now working her way through the final gates. What an inspiration she has been to this young ski team. the veteran, if you will, paid her own way early in the early years of the U.S. ski team. As you can see, she's moved into third place. The leader is Perrine Pilon, followed by Michelle Officini, and then Cindy Nelson. Now, Olga Sharapova of Czechoslovakia moves into the start house. 21 years old, she's 5'8". She's a big and bob. She goes 152 pounds, but she's had a couple of top 10 finishes in giant slalom this year. Here she is.
Well, you know, this is a pretty good course for her. She's big and strong, and that's the kind of person that would do well on a course like this. She comes from a pretty good racing background, too. Her mother was on the national team, and her father used to be the national team coach.
Never won a World Cup race, and she'd like to make it gold here.
Well, you can see her looking for speed coming down here. She's trying to time those turns and get as much out of everyone as she possibly can. You have to be careful, though, Frank, on a course like this, not to scramble too much, though.
Olga Sharapova of Czechoslovakia, been on the World Cup since 1978. Well, she's been around. She's been in pressure spots before, and she's in one now.
Well, she's getting her arms a little bit twisted down through here. We can see her getting behind here. She's actually using her poles to push off. You don't see that very often.
Now down through the lower gates, Sharapova with Perrine Pilon of France win the lead and at the bottom of the hill. Good crowd out here today. Surprisingly so, the roads were cleared and they somehow worked their way up here from Sarajevo.
Right about now, some of that new snow's getting out there on the ice, but here she comes.
Sharapova in third place, but she does not displace Perrine Pilon of France.
She had a pretty good run down through there.
Olga Sharapova has moved into second place. And the next racer we'll be watching will be Tamara McKinney. Tamara McKinney, her best event, the giant slalom, and she is a solid choice for a gold medal here at Sarajevo. And there is our leader, the veteran racer from France and a former bronze medalist from Lake Placid in this very event. So there is excitement. You can feel it here at the bottom of the hill because Tamara McKinney is coming out of the house for the U.S. Here's a young ski racer Bob and I have watched rise to the very top of the women's alpine ski world. This is Tamara McKinney. She's been in many pressure spots before, and earlier I asked her when she knew before a race that she had it all together.
We can hope. But right now I feel like skiing wise, I haven't been skiing badly, but I feel like I've been skiing well, but just without that extra energy, like I said. And now I feel rested, I feel good, and I feel excited to race, and I haven't felt that in a long time. So I think that's what sometimes makes the difference.
Now, moving into the start house, our legitimate shot for a medal and a gold medal right here at Yahoo Arena is Tamara McKinney, 21 years old. We saw her 4 years ago. She DQ'd in the GS. She's on top of the world of women's alpine skiing at the moment. She's on the course right now, Bob.
Well, I'll tell you one thing, Frank. This is going to be a great opening for the U.S. ski team because Tamara McKinney has been the best giant slalom in the world the last year. She's been struggling a little bit this year, fourth, a sixth, and a ninth. She's not particularly happy with the results. But she could get a good run here, you know, and it's a two-run course. So they reverse the time of the top five. She can get in that top five. She has a great shot here.
A quiet little girl who came in American first a year ago, and she won the overall Women's World Cup Championship. Her running time up on the top of the course. That's Sharapova. She had the best time up there. Tamara McKinney is slow up on the top. She has the fourth best time at the top of the hill. She'll really have to turn it on.
Well, she's not that far out of contention, Frank. She can really fire down here at the bottom and get them rolling. She looked a little bit stiff getting out of the starting gate. Now in giant slalom, you have to be loose and relaxed. You can make a lot of, you know, a flat hill like this, any little mistake is accidental. Looks like she goes. She hit a gate right there.
This is Tamara McKinney, and she's really hammering it down through the lower gates. Pounding those shoulders into the gates. That is the leader's time on the left. That is Pilon, and this is Tamara McKinney's running time on the right. And Tamara McKinney will be in fourth place at the moment. Pilon and Sharapova and Ray are the leaders. So Tamara McKinney had a little trouble up on the top. She made up a little time on the bottom, but she is going to have her work cut out for her in the second run. Tamara McKinney in her second Olympics, born in Lexington, Kentucky, and now resides out in Olympic Valley, California, when she's not trotting around the world as a ski racer. Her mother, Frances, a great inspiration to Tamara, put her on skis when she was a little girl, carted her back and forth in Kentucky, out to California, made a ski racer out of her. Her mother is here at the